Hello, Narnach here. Welcome back to Path of Exile. And hello, Hatebeat. How are you today? So, we are mowing through him pretty nicely. Might have something to do with the gear upgrades I did in between. So, this jacket foil is something that was actually dropped. It was in the unidentified rares that we picked up, so it might have been from the Vile Oversoul or from the early part of Sarn. Either way, this is a beauty. 78% increased physical damage, added fire, added cold. I had the prophecy that if you apply one blacksmith whetstone that you get 20% quality for it, so it was tailor-made for this, because one whetstone, 20 quality, otherwise it would have been 20 whetstones. Really useful. So, next up, I need more strength to equip my axe. So I did some creative rerolling on an Ember amulet that had some strength on it to also get some dex, since we are depending on both right now to actually be supplied by our gear to equip our weapons. Later on we'll have enough of the stats, but early on we are really confined because we're taking all kinds of useful skills rather than travel notes. And finally we have this arming axe. Just bought it as a white weapon from the vendor. It was 2+1 link, so I had to 3 link it. And this was just a lucky exalt, Opera of Alchemy. Just turned it into a rare and this came out. So every once in a while that does pay off. So, DPS is now 411, while before we were hardly hitting the 300. And as I said last time, the more damage we do, the more we leech, the better we are able to sustain ourselves. Even with faster attack speeds. So, just look at that mana, just instantly refilling itself. Where before, well, it was doing okay, but not as aggressive. So, a bit later in the piety fight, we'll actually have a foe that we can attack against for quite some time. So we can really test out how it will behave in combination with the totem, with the faster attacking a totem. See if we are mana stable that way, because that would be tremendously useful for boss fights. Because then, you know, you can achieve mana stability relatively early on already. Without having to rely on too many fancy things. So, a trial, we can skip it for this character, so that's nice. That saves us a little bit of time. Do try to remember to put the totem down every once in a while. So far, mana does not seem to be an issue. And we are there. That was rather quick.
That somber expression doesn't become those fetching features at all. Cheer up and dance.
Okay. Hello, Piety. She's dead. Cool. So this is a pretty powerhouse build if we can get her to zero life this quickly. And with that we can escape. Anything to sell? Yep. When I want, we don't use. +1 to the level of socketed gems and some added cult. Not bad. Ooh, we have prophecies on the list. Let's do that after we speak with Clarissa. Thank you for the keys. We will need that. Hello, Gregor. And Maramoa. We're gonna get Warlord's Mark, Poacher's Mark, Hatred, Grace, and Punishment. Hatred turning fist damage into cold damage might not be a bad one. We'll just grab it. We are relatively mana stable and we happen to have a green socket. No, might as well just put it in and see how it works out. Also, Argon has an optional. So, let's roll some prophecies. You will end a bloodline. Unbearable Whispers, Dome in the Library. Cursed Choir, discover an area with a large pack of sea witches. And Fire from the Sky, that's gonna be an Infernal Tempest. Okay, so Crematorium, and then we backtrack. Good thing is this is this is the area we were before, so it's not gonna trigger any prophecies. The slums, however, is gonna be a new one, I think. Oh wow, it's still active, the previous one. Nice. So we actually know where to go. Sort of, kind of. So where do we end up going? Somewhere in the corner there, yeah. So we run, we kill. Well, there's not a lot to kill anymore. Hello, Haku. Still standing there. Okay, so this was pretty close to town. It's always such a drag to walk from the center of town to the edge, so that's why I always prefer to take the waypoint and then just backtrack, even though in practice it might be longer. Okay, so we get fire from the sky. That's okay. Which means more items drops and increased rarity. Also blinded, that's gonna be less than stellar. We have to pick up a bust statue thingamajig. Flame golem, yeah, of course. You spawn from the tempest. Given that we get extra item drops here, we want to do a reasonably thorough job of killing things. Well, going for full clear is a bit too much of a hassle, but just like trying to get this one to a rare that we might not be here. Leather belt, let's ID it. And we have another room here. I've got a feeling we have to backtrack at some point. Yeah, this is already the point. Okay. Oh wait, we had hatreds with us that we could now try. So we're gonna be on very low on mana, but we have a ton of mana sustain. Also our DPS got boosted even further. It's 472 now rather than 411. So it's only 60 DPS. But if our leech is sufficient, then we could get away with it. Hello there, Spine Snap. Goodbye, Spine Snap. So we could do a one-on-one boss fight. Well, boss fight, unique fight with Hatred on. So that means we truly are mana stable. And the extra damage from Hatred is just gonna be a bonus. So as long as we got space in the build, we'll run with it. For a change, I was not gonna run with Blasphemy on this one. We still need the statue. So, no rather than reserving 35% mana for Blasphemy, we could use the 50% for Hatred. And I was planning on using Vengeance with Curse on Hit and Enfeeble as my cursing source, because probably gonna be pretty darn dodgy. Curse on hits when we do get hit seems useful. Hey, hello there, Katarina. You are standing next to the goal. All right. There were minions. Bring a corrupted minion to the sculpture. Where the opponents, you say? Well, that's a bit generous, right? A little bit too generous. So we have this minion stalking us. We haven't uncovered where to go. Does Katarina also happen to be facing in the direction? Yeah, that might be the good direction to go in. So it's gonna be somewhere up there then. And yeah, that was a blip. Excellent. So that's a It was a bit of a revelation to know that the masters actually point in the right direction. Very useful to remember. Does make it easier to navigate through the level too, especially when you're backtracking, since you do want to reduce that to an absolute minimum. And I think we ended up doing something that resembles a full clear. And we had to walk about here. So next up, next supers, which will have another bust and a waypoint. Hey, hello there, Flame Golem. Goodbye, Flame Golem. And then I think we will be able to make it to at least to the marketplace from the, from the look of it. There's nothing special going on here, so that makes it really nice. Let's see, 26, I'm 25. Okay, so I'm actually slightly under leveled, which does mean my XP will be pretty good. There's a bit of spike damage going on here, but my life is pretty solid. Resistance elemental damage is gonna be the most annoying here, but all the damage types I do resist it rather equally, which is interesting for a change. Because most of the time I'm spiking in elemental or in physical, but not really in both, at least not early on, then things are a bit mixed. Let's see, yes, there is the bust. Chromatic Orb, that's always a nice one. Giant Life Flask. Can we do something with it? Nope, we don't have that. Pick up the Tombstone. And look for the exits. And that's here. Or the blockage. Then the waypoint's over there. How is our inventory? Yeah, let's make a quick town stop. Even if it's just to get rid of the two out of the three statues. Okay, so ID all the things. Visored Salad, we already have one. This one is pretty inferior in terms of stats. It has a bit of life, but that's its only redeeming feature. We don't use daggers, and the other ones are not relevant either. Did we get coins? We got a coin, so I want a prophecy. A horror from the past returns to cause pain. Ah, the invader. You will encounter a very powerful invading monster and slay it. Ooh, cool. So we get an invasion monster in a level. Let's put this all in the sorting. Actually, let's amp this up. More recovered at a slower pace, but not bleeding. Yeah. We'll deal with fixing it with some bleeding removal or something later, but not right now. So, warehouse districts. Let's see if we already picked up the bust, so we just have to find the exit here. That's going to be very convenient. I think it might be the curve thing up there. It's often something with a curve. Travel is something that doesn't leech back mana, so using lots of whirling blades without hitting opponents is gonna be an issue. Ooh, Fagan, hello there. I did drink a potion there just to account for the spike damage he was doing. That was pretty okay. There is another one of those Kirby things. Because most of the time the exits from the sewers are in those curvy ends. That ghost is going nowhere. That was because it was a dead end. Cool. Got him. Alright, then let's check out that room over there before we push too far. And then you'll see, because I'm backtracking now to check this out, it's gonna be there. Oh wait, and skill points. Golem's Bloods, 823 life. And a full percentage point of life regen. Well, actually it was more, wasn't it? 1.6%. Okay, dead end here. Shiny stuff there. In the end, the journey is something to be enjoyed as well. And killing things is fun. At least with Lacerate to this. A lot of things you say while playing a game that are relevant to playing the game do sound strangely weird in a different context though. Killing is fun, not something you want to say outside of context of playing a game. For example. And that's another dead end. If I were the exit, where would I hide? Well, there's not a lot of places the exit could be hiding, because it all points in this direction, no? Hello? Anybody home? Home? There. Warehouse District. Also known as the game of Follow the Corpses. Yep. Okay, 14%, let's leave that where it is. And I saw an aura, that means there must be a rare here. It wasn't there. And some cross. There is no corpse here, so this is not it. There is no corpse here either. So this is not the door we have to take. Jewelers up. Ah, that's that one. This early on, they are hard to come by once you have a character that is capable of just running merciless, you will start finding more six socketed items and therefore you get more jeweler orbs. It's the fuses are the tricky buggers. Since they don't drop via any kind of recipe or easy trade-in kind of thing. So you always have to use four of these jeweler's orbs to make a fuse, or if you have access to the master, then you should get a slightly better deal. I'm assuming that's going to be 32 for 10. Ah, here, just next door. Nice burning doggies. Hello there, Blade Tooth. I don't even recognize you. But we killed you. Ah, you were an invader. Cool. Ooh, and giant life flask, which we can identify. And not interesting. Giant mana flask. That's four sips, that's not quite bad. What does it do? Nothing actually good. Now you can eventually just spam them with orbs of alteration to make them better. But that's a bit boring to watch, I personally find. So I'm not gonna do that while recording an episode. A lot of the crafting in the game is RNG, and crafting flasks is one of the most currency sinky types of crafting. Especially once you have most of your flasks set up, so you have an insta heal flask, and you have a bleeding fixing flask, and you have a poison fixing flask, and you have a curse fixing. Well, bleeding and curses are the two important ones. Poison you don't encounter all that often, so you could get away with not having one. Similarly for burning and shocking and being shocked, those are conditions you don't encounter all that often either while leveling, so those are not strictly required. Having something to fix being frozen is tremendously useful. I have a habit of putting it on my movement flasks, since it goes kind of hand in hand. Moving and not getting frozen. But once you've got most of your flasks set up and you specifically want to reroll one to like a bigger type, then you want a combination usually of prefix and suffix, and that is, well, yeah, you need to roll quite a bit to get it. Okay, so that's gonna be the last life upgrade for a while, 870. So we're now gonna scale it again with gear. Also, we're still looking for the exit. Oh, the Gemling Legion. And we're just acting like we don't care. Truth be told, we do a ton of damage. Caring is indeed slightly relative. So we came out from there, we followed the outer edge. Well, mostly, there's a little bit of an edge there, right? Might be that we have to go back just to double check that we don't advance over there. Would be annoying to backtrack further. Yeah, see. Sometimes you are lucky with those hunches. Let's see. And another town stop to empty our pockets. Let's just put everything in the sorting bin this time. Oh, we have another prophecy, so let's cash that in. Gold put in. Ah, kill a rare. That works. That might even trigger in this area if we are not really next to the extra exit. Hatred leveled up, that's nice. Ah, see, exit. Oh, there was a right there. Oh, let's actually go back. Let's kill it. Yo, die. Hey, that wasn't it. Cursed choir and a haku. Interesting. So haku first. So getting the waypoint in the marketplace is going to be our goal. Cursed Choir, I think it was one of those annoying ones where you more or less had to do a full clear of the area. Which is gonna be a bit time intensive, and I'm not quite sure what you get for it. That's the downside. Let's see, 27, okay, we actually caught up to the level. Just look at that mana regenerate itself. Wonderful. And dead end. That's not wonderful. There. Guild without, guild within. My trigger. No, it doesn't. Now, prophecies like that, I think they have a chance to trigger. Just so they don't become too predictable. Because otherwise it might be open to abuse. And there's the spirit. Hello. Oh, it's the totem spirit. That's a nasty bugger. I've lost my previous character to that. The thing is, those totems, they get respawned, if I remember. Yeah, Tahi. Their damage, it starts stacking. That's the annoying bit. Oh, we did get the boss already. So that means they probably don't get a respawn after we kill them. Ah, they're already expired. Good. Let's go back. We got double Quicksilver flasks, which is excellent for escaping from a haku mission with a spirit on your back, because you can't use movement skills. So then the spirit will just slide right off. Hello, haku. Good by Haku. So we'll have some fun with the Fated Sirens, but not gonna be an issue if you don't kill all of them. Foreseen spawn. Yes. We saw them. Okay. We could have spawned in a more fun area as well, I think, than this. But no, we can't always complain about it. Would have been nice, no, to get him in the docks or something like that. Because that's an area that's relatively okay to clear. Marketplace, I usually don't end up clearing it just because you go through it in a relatively straightforward manner. It's pretty large, there's some backtracking. And I don't know, it's not my favorite map layout. Probably because it's just a weird mix of open but also constrained in terms of navigation, because there's walls in between and partial buildings and all kinds of things like that. Hello, Marseilles. You're not Marseilles. Therefore, you must die. Kay. Next up, you. Yeah, Marseilles is red. Kay, let's put on the totem, see how that goes. Okay, I'm taking quite a lot of damage. Yeah, wait, that's I shock myself every time I hit him. Okay, so insta-heal flask does help. But this is definitely going to be interesting. We got him. Oh, keep in mind, hit and run is always a valid tactic. Especially if you need a little bit of time to recuperate, hit and run is gonna be good for you. Okay, well, as I said, I really don't like the quests that, or the prophecies that basically have you do a full clear of an area, especially not here. So I think this is gonna be a good point to call it. I mean, the episode's been going on for long enough anyway. So next episode, we're gonna make our way towards the Solaris Temple and do the docks and all the fun stuff out there. So for now, I'm gonna thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you again next time. Bye bye.